Good day, class. Welcome to the 4th and 5th session. This is our first joint session. In this session, we will briefly look at how to provide feedback to a team. As a manager, you can motivate your team members by applying techniques you gain from the research into the different theories of motivation and also based on your knowledge of your team members. There are several ideas that one can implement to influence the employee through recognizing individual differences. Each employee has unique needs. You should not treat them all the same way. You should take time to understand what's important to each team member, which will help you in individualizing goals. Level of participation and rewards to be in line with the individual's needs. There are three approaches one can take to try and motivate an employee, which could be allowing employees to participate in decisions that affect them, linking rewards to performance, or through equity. Employees can contribute to a number of decisions that affect them, such as setting work goals, choosing their own benefits packages, solving productivity and quality problems, which can increase employee productivity, commitment to work goals, motivation, and job satisfaction. If you link rewards to performance, employees should be able to see the linkage clearly. If employees think that the relation of the performance and rewards is low, it can result in a number of issues such as low performance, a decrease in job satisfaction, and an increase in turnover and absenteeism statistics. In relations to equity, rewards should be perceived by employees as equating with the inputs they bring to the job. Experience, skills, abilities, effort, and other obvious inputs should explain the differences in performance, and therefore in pay, job assignments, and other obvious rewards. You should try by all means to help the team members to understand the relationship between the reward and performance. If people think they are not being rewarded enough, they will try to restore the balance by reducing their inputs, which will lower performance. They could ask for an increase, or they could end up leaving the job. Rewards only motivate workers if the reward is fair. Money doesn't only motivate a person, but a good reward system helps satisfy the lower order needs, according to Maslow's hierarchy. Underpayment can have negative effects on the team and the organization as a whole. If individuals are dissatisfied with payment that they get, it can result in poor performance, strikes, absenteeism, high employee turnover, theft, and poor organizational climate. We have come to an end of the session. We will continue with the last session after a break.